Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching TV 38 WADL. Ladies and gentlemen, we have talked to cardiologists. We have talked to urologists. But we haven't talked to anybody about women's health. In order to do that, I'm going to introduce you today to Dr. Cheryl Moore. She is a Spelman graduate for undergrad. She is a Wayne State graduate for medical school. She's an accomplished doctor practicing in metropolitan Detroit. Dr. Moore, how are you today?
Good morning. It's a pleasure to be here.
I'm glad you're here. Look, once again, take us through it again. What are some of the leading causes of death in Detroit, death for African Americans in Detroit? Everybody.
Well, the leading cause of death in Detroit is the same as it is all over the country, and that's heart disease. That's the number one killer of Americans. Mm-hmm. And in Detroit, it's just more prevalent. Also, causes that are leading causes as well, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which is usually brought on by smoking, diabetes, stroke, and of course, cancer.
Okay, tell me this. What is the most important thing? We've talked about men's health and all that. What's the most important thing for women to look out for? I mean, in their health, what they should be looking out for? I mean, why should they be going to a doctor? Why should we even go to an internist?
Well, first of all, the internist is the center of your health care.
Okay.
Should be your advocate, mm-hmm. someone you trust, someone you respect, and someone who will guide you through the system in terms of what other specialists you may need or who you should see mm-hmm. for particular problems. Women in general need to commit to healthcare. They should be participants, and they should also prioritize their healthcare. And that's the main thing that isn't done.
When you say prioritize their healthcare, what do you mean by that?
It should be one of the things that you think about regularly. Okay. You want to, not that you're at the actual office a lot or at the doctor's office or in tests, but you want to make it part of your life and include it in your daily plans and live as if it is a priority.
What tests should women have? What should they come to the doctor for?
Well, women and men, both. But since our topic today is about women, women should know all of their numbers. They should know what their blood pressure is, which should be 120 over 80 to 130 over 80. Should know what their blood sugar is, or glucose, which is 100 mm-hmm. for fasting. Should know their BMI, which is a body mass index, takes into account your weight and your height, and that should come out between 18.5 and 24.5. They should also know their cholesterol values, their total cholesterol, as well as their good and bad cholesterols.
So instead of just knowing the daily three number, 454, wheel, box, whatever, they've got to know their real numbers.
Their real numbers.
Because, you know, I see people at the lottery machine all the time. They can call those numbers all the time, but do they know their real numbers that keep them alive?
Absolutely. And these are their main things that they should know. In terms of prevention, of course, mammograms are necessary. A baseline mammogram is recommended between ages 35 and 40. After age 40, the mammograms are recommended once a year. That should be in conjunction with monthly breast exams that women should be taught how to perform
monthly
by their
breast
physicians.
Exams?
Yes.
Okay.
That they do on their own every mm-hmm. month. And then, of course, a pelvic exam and a pap smear.
Okay.
And then the pap smear is needed every year until about age 65, and then every 3 years. And the pelvic exam should continue in order to evaluate your ovaries.
That's a whole lot of maintenance.
It is a whole lot of maintenance, but it's a good way to stay here and be healthy.
Okay. Speak on being healthy. Are there any special foods women should eat?
Well, women should start early in their adolescent years and early adulthood with their calcium. Mm-hmm. And calcium usually would include vitamin D. And that's just to protect their bones later in life. And that's specific to women, but not to exclude men, because their bone health is just as important, but not nearly as fragile once we reach menopause age. The other foods are both for men and women in terms of diet. There is loads of evidence now that's out saying that we should really have more of a plant-based diet, much inspired by Mediterranean foods, grains, nuts, beans, fruits, vegetables, olive oil, and those types of things would be the basis of your meal.
No Whoppers?
No Whoppers.
What about pop? Should women be drinking pop?
You know, I'm going to say no, just in general, just because it's very high in sugar, and sugary drinks add calories, and one of the biggest problems amongst women is obesity, and that's just a way to eliminate calories. I know a lot of women who love their Pepsi, and if you just can't do without it, then, you know, just do it in moderation. Certainly not something you should drink on a daily basis.
What are studies showing on coffee, caffeine and coffee?
Because
I know a lot of women just like love to consume their coffee.
Recent evidence that there may be some protection against Alzheimer's with the use of coffee. I would say that no more than a cup a day, and if you can, use decaffeinated coffee or decaffeinated beverages just to lower your blood pressure, and some people are very anxious when they drink too much caffeine.
Tell me, anxiety and
stress, you know, can lead to other diseases as well.
So to recap, the woman's body is her temple. How often should that temple be checked for problems?
Everyone should have an annual exam. The things that we've already discussed should be included. A history is very important. And that just means things that have occurred with you in your past, what medications you take, if any, if you use any supplements, if you know your family's history, that's generally important, if you have that information. But if you have none, if you don't know any of that information, still come. And we can put together a great program for you without any information.
Where can people find Dr. Cheryl Moore?
I am located in the DMC complex at Lasser and 11 Mile in Southfield. My office is open 5 days a week, and I'm there seeing patients every day.
And the number to that office is?
Our phone number is 248-603-2410.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you had that pen out. Now, when we come back, we're going to get into a little bit of men's health and a little bit of family health, because Dr. Moore is an all-encompassing internist. You need to hear this. Your health is your greatest asset. I'm Steve Hood. This is Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching WADL TV 38.
Detroit Wants to Know is sponsored in part by the Associated Food and Petroleum Dealers, working with you to make Detroit a safer place. If you see a crime, call 1-800-SPEAK-UP.
Welcome back. You're watching Detroit Wants to Know. This is TV 38 WADL. When we left off, Dr. Moore was talking to us about women's health and diet and taking care of the temple. Dr. Moore, women are often the driving force of getting their men to take care of their own health. It starts with diet, doesn't it?
It does. And because the women are the driving force, generally the women control.
I like the fact that women are the driving force.
We buy the groceries. Generally, the women are the shoppers as well as the food preparers. So it stands to reason that that part of a men's health is easily affected by what we do, and we can control a little of that.
Okay, what should they be buying for their man at the market?
As I indicated before, more of a plant-based diet. As we move, I would say we'll use that as our base. And as we move up, then we would include fish and seafood. And these numbers are, or amounts are actually getting smaller as we go to the top. Mm-hmm. So we should have less fish and seafood than plant-based fruits, vegetables, grains, herbs, and then we should have even less poultry, cheese, eggs, and then even less meats and sweets. And in fact, meats and sweets are really recommended now to be limited to maybe 2 or 3 times a month.
Meats and sweets?
Yes, meats and sweets.
Wait. I had a Kit Kat on the way here, but I had one yesterday, so I've already blown it.
You've had your amount for the month.
I've had my amount of Kit Kat for the month.
That's it.
That's a bad thing. Okay, how should the male be prepared for the appointment? What if a man has ED and he comes to see you? Should he be embarrassed to talk about that?
Well, you know, should is a hard word. And I would say, if you have ED, feel comfortable with wherever you seek your health care. If you feel comfortable speaking to me about it, then we should handle it there. I will ask you that as part of your history when you come to see me. I will also ask women that about their sexual health as well. So part of participating in your health is finding a doctor that you are comfortable with, that you trust, respect, and who will be your advocate. So if those things are taken into account, then I think our discussions about even issues surrounding sexuality should easily be part of our discussion. Once again, find a doctor you're comfortable discussing those things with, be they male or female.
Okay. Doc, I want to thank you for coming. This is Steve Hood. You're watching Detroit Wants to Know. Your health is your primary focus. Your body is a temple. Take care of that temple. Don't let it fall into ruin. Don't let it look like a blighted house in Detroit. You're watching Detroit Wants to Know. This is WADL-TV. Hit me up on Facebook or at stevehooddetroit.com. Have a great rest of the weekend.
Skin. Run, 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 but you sure can't hide.